Hi, let's talk about the cardiac veins. As you may know, there are two major sets of cardiac veins. There's the greater system, with most of the tributaries flowing directly into the coronary sinus, which delivers blood into the right atrium. And then there's the lesser or the small system, which consists of the Bcn veins, which drain the subendocardial myocardium directly into the chambers where they exist. Now, these Thebesian veins are in greatest concentrations in the right atrium. They're in the lowest densities in the left ventricle. They're not particularly well studied, and we won't discuss them much more here simply because they're not grossly visible. So let's see what we are able to see as part of the greater system. And let's begin with the great cardiac vein. The great cardiac vein, which we can see there, occupies the anterior interventricular sulcus and is partnered with the anterior interventricular branch of the LCA. The great cardiac vein is going to flow up toward the coronary sulcus, where it rides the sulcus around to the left border, or the pulmonary border of the heart, where it feeds directly into the coronary sinus. So let's take a look at that. So we've just rotated the heart around. Here is that diaphragmatic surface. There's the inferior vena cava. And here we can see quite a large coronary sinus, which will be flowing into the right atrium. So, great into the coronary sinus. There's also a middle cardiac vein. The middle cardiac vein occupies the posterior interventricular sulcus with the posterior interventricular branch of what is typically the RCA, but which may also be from the LCA or both LCA and RCA. Nevertheless, that middle cardiac vein feeds into the coronary sinus. There is also a small cardiac vein. The small cardiac vein is there, and it is typically associated with the right marginal branch of the RCA. And that small cardiac vein moves along that inferior border of the heart into the coronary sulcus, where it meets up with the coronary sinus. Now, there are also anterior cardiac veins, and usually there are about 3 to 5 of these. I can see one right there. I can see another one right there. These usually are avulsed during dissection because they're so delicate, but if they're present, we can immediately identify them because they are going to jump over the RCA in draining the right ventricle, and they're going to feed directly into the right atrium. So they're the only veins of the greater system which drain independently of the coronary sinus. Thank you very much for your time.